Hello.
Good morning, student. How are you? I think you all are fine at your home and enjoy your holiday. Okay, in the class 7th science series, in the first video, we are discuss about the nutrition in the plants, and there are two types of the nutrition found in the plant. First is the autotrophic mode of nutrition and second is the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. In last video, we discussed about the autotrophic mode of nutrition. Now in this chapter, in this video, we will discuss about the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. What do you mean by the heterotrophic mode of nutrition? On the last video, I tell you what is the heterotrophic. Hetero means other. Hetero means other. When the plant depend on the other for their food is called heterotroph. The plant is called heterotrophs, and the mode of nutrition is called heterotrophic. No confusion. The plant which cannot make their own food but depend on the other for their food is called heterotrophs, and this mode of nutrition is called heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Corpus flower, Rafflesia, mushroom, they are all example of the heterotrophic plant. There are a different method in the heterotrophic mode of nutrition through which plant get their food. First is the parasitic mode of nutrition, saprophytic mode of nutrition, symbiotic mode of nutrition, and insectivorous mode of the nutrition. One by one we will discuss. First is the parasitic mode of nutrition. Parasite. What do you mean by the parasite? Parasite that live on the others. Yeah. So that plant which is live on the other plants and get their all the foods from that plants are called parasite. And this type mode of nutrition is called parasitic mode of nutrition. The plant absorb the nutrition from the other plants is called parasite. These plants are not green because green color of the plant because of the green pigment chlorophyll, so they have no chlorophyll. You see this diagram, there is a branch of a green tea and one another plant revolving around that is called cascuta. This is called cascuta. And in Hindi name Amarbel. This is a parasitic plant. It depend on their food for their plants. That is yellowish in color, not in the green color. Okay. Next, saprophytic mode of nutrition means the plant which get their food by the dead and decaying matter. And these organisms are called saprophytes. The mode of nutrition is called saprophytic mode of nutrition, and the organism and plants are called saprophytes. Understand that get their food from the dead and decay matter. Next, there's a mushroom. You see, mushroom always grow on a dirty place. Dirty place means they are the lot of the dead plants, dead animals are there, so they are grow. Because they take their food from that dead plants and dead animals, it absorb the nutrition from here. Okay. Next example, you see this type of bread at your home and the black spots are come after 2 and 3 days. What is this? This is the mushroom which are take their food from this bread, so these breads are spoiled. Next is the symbiotic nutrition. Symbiotic nutrition, you say organism which live together and they share shelter and food. Best example of symbiotic nutrition is the lichen. Lichen is the association of two organisms. First is the algae and second is the fungi. Algae is the green in color, but this is the not green in color. So how they make their own food? Green algae have the chlorophyll, so it is able to absorb the sunlight. It have also stomata, so it is able to take carbon dioxide from the environment. But what it do? It take nutrition from the soils, so that is water and minerals. And these lichens are live on this fungus. So it gives shelter, it gives food. So mutual understanding, that is called symbiotic nutrition. What is the symbiotic nutrition? Organism which live together, they share shelter and food. In the lichen, algae give the food to the fungus and fungus give shelter to the algae. So they are mutually benefit for each other. You see in the pulses, this is the pulses, pea, mungs and beans. In their roots, there are a bacteria that is called rhizobium bacteria. Root and the rhizobium bacteria has symbiotic relationships. What the rhizobium bacteria is doing? Rhizobium bacteria fix the atmospheric nitrogen, and that nitrogen easily absorbed by that plant, and plant give the food to that rhizobium bacteria. So they are symbiotic in the relationship. Understand? Next is the insectivorous mode of nutrition. Insect, you listen about the insect. Insectivorous means that it insect. Insectivorous nutrition means, mode of nutrition means insect eating plants. There's a Venus flytrap and the picture plant. This is the picture plant. They're shaped like a funnel. When the insect come here, it close it, and these insects are digested by this plant. Like that, in the Venus flytrap, there are a small hair-like structure. The insect are come here, and these hairs catch that insect, and this plant are eat that insect. Okay. Today we are discussing the heterotrophic mode of nutrition in the plants. There are four methods we are discussing in this video. First is the parasitic mode of nutrition, means the plant live on the other plants. They take their own food from the other plants. Second is the saprophyte. Saprophytes means the plant take their food from the decay and dead matter. Third one is the symbiotic relationship, when the two organisms live with each other in the symbiotic relationship, mutual understanding. One give the shelter and one give the food for them. Okay, and fourth one, the insectivorous mode of the nutrition. It means the plant eat the insect for fulfill its nutrition. Okay, I think you enjoy this session. Thank you. We meet in the next video. Bye-bye.